You obviously acquit yourself very well. And those of us who know you and work with you have mostly, I know many of us, I'll include me, and I'll say most of us, actually.
I'm going to go with him this time.
Okay. We have tremendous faith in your ability to make things happen, and we thank you for all the issues you're taking on. You're building a great culture in the State Department, bringing on people that are truly exemplary. We feel the same way about Secretary Mattis, the way he conducts himself and what he does. I think there's tremendous faith on both sides of the aisle in his abilities and what he does. Much of what you're hearing today has nothing whatsoever to do with you, and I would agree with you that the policies that we're putting in place in many cases are stronger than have ever been put in place. I agree with you. It's the president that causes people to have concerns. And I'd love to have some insights into you as to, for instance, at the Helsinki conference, to create an equivalence between our intelligence agency and what Putin is saying, that shocks people. I mean, you can imagine you saw Dan Coats' response afterwards, and yours today, I think, candidly was related to what he said at Helsinki. And then the notion of even thinking about exchanging diplomats, sending diplomats over to be interrogated by Putin, to even think about that, to let that be said as an official statement coming out of the White House to, this is my opinion, and I believe it's right, to purposely cause the American people to misunderstand about the NATO contributions and to cause them to doubt NATO and to really drive public opinion against NATO. That, to me, was purposeful, not unlike what happened right after Charlottesville. And then Article 5, to go on television and say, why would we honor, I'm paraphrasing, but why would we honor Article 5 in Montenegro? You know, we passed a law, I think only two people dissented, to send them into NATO. He signed it. I mean, it would be a dereliction of duty if he did cause that to be the case. So why does he do those things? I mean, is there some strategy behind creating doubt in U.S. senators' minds on both sides of the aisle, doubt in the American people as to what his motivations are, when we, in fact, have tremendous faith in you? I think you're a patriot. Tremendous faith in Mattis. But it's the president's actions that create tremendous distrust in our nation, among our allies. It's palpable. We meet and talk with them. Is there a strategy to this, or is it, what is it that causes the president to purposely create distrust in these institutions and what we're doing?
Senator, I disagree with most of what you just said there. You somehow disconnect the administration's activities from the president's actions. They're the one and the same. Every sanction that was put in place was signed off by the president of the United States. Every spy that was removed was directed by the president.
Go to the points I just made. Go to the points I just made. Talk to them. Talk to them. I know what we're doing.
Here's what the world needs to know. Okay. With respect to Russia, this administration has been tougher than previous administrations, and I fully expect it will. The president's own words were, he's happy to figure out if we can make improvements with respect to the relationship between he and Vladimir Putin and change the course. But if not, he'll be there. I'll get the words wrong. He'll be their toughest enemy, most difficult enemy. I think I can prove that that's the case today. I think I have.
Yeah.
And so somehow there's this idea that this administration is free-floating. This is President Trump's administration, make no mistake, who's fully in charge of this, and who is directing each of these activities that has caused Vladimir Putin to be in a very difficult place today.
Yeah. Well, look, you handle yourself in exactly the way you should, in my opinion, as it relates to comments. I notice that you are not responding to what I'm saying.
I think I responded to everything that you
said. Well, it's over. What are you going to do?
No, you didn't. And the fact is that you just didn't, okay?
We disagree, Senator.
No, we don't disagree. Hell, let's run the transcript again if you want to talk about it. But the fact is
we'll let the world decide.
It's the president's public statements that create concern amongst senators on both sides of the aisle. And I was asking you if, in fact, there was some rhyme or reason that this type of distrust or discord will be created. And I know you're not going to answer the question, I'm trying to make a point as to why.
I know you are.
Why the opening comments and the questions and just the energy behind this hearing are what they are. It's not about you, and it's not about Mattis, and it's not what we're doing on the ground.
Senator, you went through a long litany of statements, but let me give you. First of all, I will tell you, I talk to the same allies you do. I speak to their foreign ministers directly. It is the case that they are behaving differently today. There's no doubt about that. They are now scrambling to figure out how to make sure that they are fully part of NATO. Some of that is a result of the statements that you referred to, Senator.
Yeah.
Some of that is identifying Nord Stream 2 as a problem.
I actually agree with that. Yeah, I agree with that.
Right. These are there you go. I'll let the record reflect.
I'll say some of these
statements actually achieve important policy outcomes for the United States of America.
Some of them do.
Yep.
And some of them very damaging.